Hey guys, it's Tori again with Fox and Hazel, and today I'm going to show you guys how to make a watercolor background for your bullet journal. So the secret tool you're going to need here is called gesso. If you're an art journaler, you're familiar with it. If you're not, it's just basically like a primer that artists use on their canvases, and so we're going to use it to prime our bullet journal. And so I'm kind of whipping through it here in the video, but what you're going to do is take the gesso and use a credit card or like an old gift card, and you're gonna paint a super super thin layer of gesso on your bullet journal page, like super super thin. I can still see all the dots on my background and it's not wrinkling my page because it's such a thin layer on there. That's why this credit card is perfect to use it, because you can scrape off all the extra. You kind of scrape it on and then scrape off the excess, so it makes this super thin transparent layer, as you can see here. See, I can still see everything. So what you'll do then is either let it dry, or like you can do what I did, which is I used a heat gun to dry it. I ran off and dried it because I'm impatient. And so now our background is prepped to accept some watercolor. And the palette I'm using here is the Kuretake Ganzai Tambi 36 watercolor count. I apologize, I probably butchered that. Anyways, and I'm just using a water brush. And then, yeah, you're just going to paint on a really fun background. I chose to go with sort of blues and purples for mine. You can do whatever you want. I will say that if you have used watercolors in the past, when you put gesso down, it reacts differently with the watercolors. So what the gesso does is that it seals our page. So when you go to put something that's a water-based medium, so watercolor, on top of it, it won't leak through to the paper underneath. It creates a sort of waterproofing seal, if you will. So that's why also when you go to put the gesso on, you want to make sure you get everywhere covered with a fairly even layer, because if you skip a spot, then it will leak through and show on the other side of your bullet journal. And so, yeah, this is like the fun part. You just play around and do whatever you want. And this bullet journal is not a nice one. I got it off Amazon for $6. I don't even know what the brand is. So if it works on this bullet journal, then it should be good if you have nicer ones, because I'm sure there are people who have much nicer bullet journals than mine out there. I'm new to bullet journaling. It's like a whole new world, and I quite like it because I could never find a planner that really suited what I needed. But at the same time, I am not type A enough or organized enough for some of the extreme ends of bullet journaling. And so I've sort of created my own version of it. And that's including art and some kind of like color and creativity in the bullet journal itself. So this second palette I've pulled out is the Finitech Mica Gold palette. I believe they rebranded. Somebody had shared with me, and I think it's, oh, I can't even say it. It's Colirico. It's Colirico. Anyways, and as you can see, these are these really luscious metallic mica-based watercolors. And so I'm just getting some of that. This is like really pale gold, and then just splattering it all over the page to get a nice little speckled effect, a little shimmer, because no page is complete in my world unless there's a metallic on it. And so I just run off quickly again and dry that with my heat gun. Again, you don't have to do that. That's just because I'm impatient. And so now here we are. My background's totally done. It's set up and I can do whatever I want for my layout on top. And so you guys get to watch me struggle to put my layout on there. I think that's kind of good, because like I see lots of Instagram videos and stuff of people who have been bullet journaling along longer time, and they always seem to like just know what they're doing, and I feel like I'm always forever scratching my head and trying to figure it out, especially because like math is not my strong suit. And so trying to like count out all the dots and get the division right and spacing and stuff like that has been not hard, but just, you can see me, I count everything over several times, and so, yeah. And I'm also actually just like a one pager. So like I when I was looking for inspiration for bullet journal layouts, I found a lot that were like a double page spread, like for a week. So you would plan out your week, but it would be in like two pages, and that's way too much for me. Like I never have enough information going on, because what I do is I set up one page with like my week at a glance, and then on the pages following, I use each page or half a page as like my to-do list for the day. So, you know, I'll write down as I'm working through projects and appointments for my kids and all that stuff, but I don't write necessarily all the detailed information in the actual weekly calendar. I just basically put appointments in there so I don't forget, you know, when my kid has dance class or has a doctor's appointment. And so I found actually this layout was a spin off of the one that I found by Megan over on Page Flutter, which is probably where you came from. If you go look through her blog, I'll link to it in the video too and in the post, one of her one-page weekly layouts. I kind of had started on that one and I've sort of tweaked it just a tiny bit as I've gone on to sort of suit myself more. But it was great because I could not find anything else on Pinterest or Instagram that was a single-page weekly layout. And like I said, I just have no use for a double page layout. I know lots of people love them, but like I don't do trackers. I don't make like goal lists or like anything like that. I basically just needed a spot to be able to write down things I'm doing this week so I don't forget them. And then also like a to-do list every single day. You know, this is my plan. What am I going to do with all that? And I actually also like including a meal planner into mine. Because otherwise every day I'm like, I don't know what I'm making. And I also end up buying the wrong things at the grocery store and then, you know, things go to waste. And so, yeah, I'm a meal planner. I always have been. And I like having that in here because then I can sort of plan my meals out and know if I need what I need and if I can make, you know, more meals out of X amount of groceries, that kind of thing. And if you probably missed it because you're listening to me ramble, but I actually messed up this part counting out all my spaces, and then I drew a line and realized that I kind of had, you know, not counted correctly and stuff. So I just kind of ran with it and made my meal planning box smaller, and then chose to decorate the outside to make up for my errors of my wild pen that got out of control on me. And yeah, I also like kind of like doodling on some of it just to add some pizzazz. I know some people vary all the way from like really decorative bullet journals all the way to like very minimalist ones. And I'm kind of, I guess, in between. I don't really want like a ton of doodles, but I like something a little bit flashier. And so I had this line at the bottom now that I had no use for. And so I decided to turn it into like a cute little box that I put some, like a little sentiment in it to encourage me for the week. And I am not a hand lettering pro by any means. And so if you're not, then we can hang because that is not my skill set. And so, yeah. And so the plus side too is having this gesso on top is that the pen writes really nice on it because it's less of like a rough paper. It's more of like a smooth surface. I will say though that because it's smooth, it doesn't absorb as well. So if you use stuff that takes a little bit longer to dry, I would just be mindful that you don't smudge it. This ink pad, for example, I don't smudge it, but I was super careful with it because the ink, it's like a archival ink. So it stays wet for quite a bit afterwards. And so if it was on like regular paper, it would just soak in right away. But I find that when I use it on top of acrylics or on top of more sealed surfaces, it just takes longer to dry. So I just have to be careful. And this is a really cute stamp set I got off Amazon. It's actually like a kid's educational, like lowercase alphabet set. I have the uppercase and lowercase. And I totally bought them telling myself I was going to let my kids use them. And now they're mine because I love using them in all my art journals and in my bullet journal here. And you may have noticed that when I set up my bullet journal, I start my weeks on Mondays. And I know that people vary. Like all our calendars for everything else start on Sunday, but I personally start mine on Mondays because that's how I roll. My Mondays feel like the start of the week to me. So that's how I like to plan it. And so here I'm just using some Tombow dual brush pens just to fill in the dates for my week. So if you wanted to, you could totally use the same layout and just keep, like, you know, make several of them for the whole month of December if you really wanted to, and then just go in afterwards and fill in the dates as needed if you felt like it. Just saying. And yeah. And again, I'm not a hand lettering pro here, but I quite like these. I inherited these a bunch from my mom. She bought them all thinking she was going to learn how to, you know, do brush calligraphy, and then realized that wasn't her jam. And so she gave them all to me, which I was happy to take them from her. And so the last little bit I'm using just to add some detail, because that's how I am, is a Stabilo All pencil. It's just a water soluble pencil. And this one's navy blue. I thought it would look nice. If you choose to use something like this, just be mindful of whatever pen you used. I was using a Papermate Flair, and they are, I believe they're water soluble, because I was mindful to make sure my brush tip didn't touch it or like go over the line, because it smudged a little bit and wanted to come away with it. So yeah, if you're going to use that, just be mindful of whatever pen you're using, which I'd love recommendations. If you guys are bullet journalers, which I know you are, if you came from Page Flutter, please hit me up with your favorite pens that you love to use in your bullet journals. I'm all yours. I want to know. So yeah, this is the finished page. It's super simple, but like having the watercolor background is just enough color, but without being overwhelming. And yeah, that's it. So thanks so much for watching, you guys. If you want to follow more of my stuff, make sure you hit that subscribe button, and that you can always be up to date when I have new videos. And if you have something you want to share with me, like a bullet journal, art journal, make sure you hit me up on Instagram. Bye, guys.